how to do a static or a diode test. Today we're gonna cover how to do these tests on an A frame, B frame, C frame, and D frame, and how to find out what size frame your drive is. We're also gonna go over the why and how to do a static check as well. On an A-frame drive, everything's gonna be at the bottom. You have your DC plus, DC minus, motor terminals, and your mains right here. On a B-frame like this, it's a little bit different and actually a little bit easier to access. You have your DC plus, DC minus, all right up here, just enough room to put your leads onto the bus. This one has a disconnect option. Not all drives do, but some do. You can use the top of these screws here to make sure you have a connection when you're doing this. Just make sure that those are tight so that you don't have an abnormal reading. And then you may have to remove one of these plates, but as long as you have access to the UV and W, you'll be able to tell based off of the results that we'll go over here in just a little bit that you have, in fact, a good test point. C frame like this, similar to the B frame. You have your DC plus, DC minus here. D frame is just like the B and the C frame. The only difference is these test points are actually gonna be recessed back a little bit farther. On your drives, you're gonna need a couple of things, some tools to get your drive open, and then you're gonna need a multimeter. This one happens to be a Fluke 87 Max, but really you just need to make sure you have one that has the diode setting on there. There's other tests you can do, like a resistance test, but we primarily are just gonna focus on doing a static test using the diode. All right, after we verified that our DC bus is all the way down, we can just check for the diode drops across the SCRs on the input and the IGBTs on the output section. So we will go positive to negative, and then we will go right there. So 0.49 is actually a good diode drop, and that's what we want. That's really good. So that would be the same thing as taking our positive lead, going to the negative bus right here and checking L1, L2, and L3 if I don't block it all the way. So it'd be like checking L1, L2, and L3, right? So same thing. So check that, and now we're gonna check our IGBTs as well. And that's the main part that we want. We just wanna see a diode drop across. So we'll check our positive, go to our positive, and you can see we actually are charging that bus up a little bit. That's what we call infinity. We don't want to charge it all the way up. We just want to double check and see that we don't have any shorts on the caps. So it's not a full capacitor test. Again, we're just making sure we can take energy from the input, send it to the bus, and vice versa. Just make sure those diodes are functioning the way they're supposed to. So negative lead to our positive bus, and then we'll go diode drop. Ooh, and you can see right there, that one's a little bit high. We usually want to stay between 0.38 and about 0.5, but you can see that L2 is actually a little bit higher if the other two are about 0.47, so not too bad, but it is higher than I'd like it to be. And we have a good diode drop across the other ones there. Great, so that's actually all of it other than just this last one here where we reverse, go positive to positive, and check for that infinity as well. Yep, right there as well, right there. Get our last two really quick. Now, if you were to just leave it on here, now you can see that it says OL. And sometimes we get some confusion on what OL actually is, and we just write OL. That's not infinity. It may just mean that you have energy on your bus, and we're not able to test to see if we have the SCRs able to transmit energy back to the DC bus. So make sure your drive has sat, double check it using your voltmeter, and just make sure that that is at as low as possible before you start, so we can check that. And so these readings are gonna be a little bit different. Main difference is you're not gonna get a diode drop on one of those input tests. Instead, it should be a reading to infinity. So I'm gonna do this one a little bit different because I think I actually did find that we may have a short inside of here, but I'll post the correct readings after this. So we're gonna go ahead and start with our positive or negative here. And we're gonna go here and show you diode drop right there. That's good. And if you do wanna save time doing this, you again can actually just jump right over to your output section and check for your diode drop there. But again, just make sure you record your results that way as well. So let's go ahead and reverse our meter leads and make sure we have a good connection. And right here, we should be seeing a reading to infinity, but instead it just says OL. And according to the manual, oh, there we go. There we have our charge up right there. So I may not have had a good connection, so sometimes it's good to actually get a good connection, verify that you do have a good connection. That is a reading to infinity on our output section here. But again, we don't have it on our input, so could be an issue there. The main test, though, that we are looking at is when we go negative meter lead to positive. We're looking for those diode drops, right? So making sure that we have that on our input section as well. Because again, this should be our reading to infinity. But it's not. It's actually just reading oh well. And we have that across there, so we have a good connection. So we're going to go ahead and swap our leads here. Go positive to positive. We're going to get our reading to infinity here as well. And we do have a reading to infinity here, which is good. So just make sure you don't have that DC bus charged up. Make sure if you just see that voltage start to climb up, you're jumping right to the next point when you're testing it, because again, otherwise you're going to charge it up and you'll just read oh well across all. Again, that is just showing open, but we're looking actually for infinity. So if you do have any questions, go ahead and feel free to reach out. We'll go ahead and help you with those results. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you found this helpful. If you liked our video today, feel free to drop a comment or press the like button as well. We're always putting out more content to try to help all of you diagnose any other issues and help troubleshoot your drives even better. We also have a brand new My Drive Assistant as well that has tons of information as well as tips and tricks available 24/7 for you at mydriveassistant.com. Thanks for watching.